Urban Explorers with your host, Jay Schreck. I'm doing a little bit of urban exploring today, and I'm in Mesa, Arizona. You know, one of our viewers, Steve Lyons, came by here, and after he showed me pictures of this place, I had to come down and see it for myself. Look at this. In 1935 to 1947, Ted and Beth Sliger homesteaded this area. You know, it was about 9 years before they even got electricity to their homestead. And one day they were digging a well, and when they hit water, what they found was water that was coming out at 127 degrees. So all of a sudden, Ted and Beth Sliger had hit hot springs. And so what happened next was this incredible Buckhorn bass. Now this place, in its heyday, was where you would see Hollywood's elite and some athletes. You might know their name even today, because there was a team called the New York Giants before they became San Francisco, that basically started the first cactus league in Arizona. And so the likes of Willie Mays and Ty Cobb became really great close friends to Ted and Beth, and they became honorary Giants and traveled with the team all around the world. Look at this place, it is so incredible. Look how big it is. My gosh. So he also had a collection of taxidermy that there were 450 heads that he actually had on display. So he made this kind of a museum and, you know, a hotel, hot baths. Look at this motor court. Is this Scream Route 66 or not? Look at this place. Even today, in this dilapidated condition, this place is incredible. I can't believe how neat this really is. It's absolutely unbelievable. I wish they would restore this, because I tell you what, this is an incredible piece of property. Now, all over there is places where, look at this little house. Man, how incredible is that? And then hot springs ran all through this area. Look at this old drinking fountain. Man, how incredible is this? All over this property are all kinds of different... That is unbelievable. Look at this place. Looks like a shuffleboard court right here. Man, in its heyday, this place would have been absolutely unbelievable. Now today, we might be crackhead hunting, because that's the only thing that you gotta worry about in this area, part of Mesa today, is meth heads and things like that. And so we're gonna be very cautious because we're not hunting meth heads today. I do have my tennis shoes on. I could run extremely fast. I am armed, as always. And we're gonna take a look around here, even though I don't think we're supposed to be here. I'm not going to pass on this. I'm gonna have to look at this place. It's so incredible. I can imagine in its heyday, these Hollywood elites and all these baseballs, Ty Cobb, Willie Mays, it doesn't get any more epic than that. And they created this environment by doing something as simple as digging a well, right? And all of a sudden, look at this barbecue pit area. Oh my God, here's more of these. Look at, if you guys know what these are, right? I've never seen this many in my entire life. Look at that. One viewer said, no wonder there's none of them out in the open. And that is very true. Look at these petroglyphs. It's sad to see all this in this condition. I don't think people really realize what this is and what they have here. I saw the wall in front, but I never saw this one here. This is absolutely unbelievable. You know, I just noticed this head right here. Look at that tool head. I just noticed that out of, you know, stumbling around here. There's so much stuff in these walls. I mean, how incredible is these stones? I mean, if you go through here, I'm just in awe. There's a petroglyph right there. I mean, this stuff's all over. Who would ever thought I'd have seen a tool head coming around here? Man. I just can't believe there's this many of these. Now, the gentleman that is basically the guard here said that they used to sell a lot of Indian stuff, a lot of blankets and pots and things like that. And the gentleman said, hey, you know what? If you get any matates or any of that kind of stuff, I'd love to have them. And I guess they brought stuff off the reservation in truckloads. So, man, look at these walls. They're just unbelievable. I can't even imagine how many are here. I've never seen anything like this. This is like biggest collection. He says the biggest collection in the world, and I'd absolutely believe it. Look at that branding irons in that thing. This wall is just like, I mean, look at this. It's incredible.
Amazing.
It's unbelievable.
And you got the heart stone. This is one that everybody's looking for to match the ones they found up in Superstition.
Okay.
Turn it over to the map.
Well, look at these. I just saw... Look at these tools. They're everywhere.
I have a lot of fun with this. I saw the stones the other day, or either replicas, at the Goldfield Museum.
Yeah.
They had the stones.
Yeah, yeah. He was telling me that they would kill a buffalo and they would feed 3,000 people in this area. 3,000 people. That, man, that's unbelievable. Right. How long have you been on the property?
I've actually been here about since 2016.
Okay, so you've been here a while.
My mother worked here 41 years.
Really? So that's your tie-in to the family?
This is my mother here.
Oh, that's awesome.
And then I have another picture of her. This here was an artist that stayed here on the property.
Okay.
George Frederick. And there's 52 of his paintings still left in the museum. This painting here is in the previous owner's house in Apache Junction.
Wow.
This one he did from a sketch of the front of the building, sitting where the Jack in the Box is.
It's unbelievable.
This is his sketch of Marilyn and Teddy Jr.
Okay.
He lives in Apache Junction. She's deceased. And her son has stole every painting of her that was in the museum.
Right. So the museum had it. It was a full-blown museum at one time.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Because I read that, but I didn't see a lot of stuff that was in it. So he had a lot of art, a lot of, you know, oh my God, how beautiful is that?
A lot of it. Now
and that book is, can I see the cover? I just want to tell people, if you want to look in deeper, look at that book right there. Old Motor Lodges, you know, Ernie Banks, Willie Mays, all these guys were down here. Ty Cobb. I mean, all the people that you know, made baseball, you know, was such a great sport. Well, we know that there was a beauty shop. We know that they had bass. All these casitas basically have baths. They don't have showers. So you'd have to go to the showering side, which would be where the hot springs were at anyway. Now, Dan told me this right here is a pond, basically a fish pond. It's not a swimming pool. A lot of people thought it was a swimming pool, but you know, Bob Hope was here. I mean, John Wayne was here. Everybody was in this location. This place is beautiful. It's got soul, but I hope they preserve it and they take care of it and they keep some of it. You know, they'll probably put high-rise apartments on it, but I'll tell you what, I'd hate to see this go. I hope they can work it in where they take care of it and they keep some of this history alive. I tell you, it's so unbelievable. You know, they had a museum here, 450 stuffed animals. They sold a lot of artifacts, things like that. You look at these grounds and you wander around. That old truck kind of brings back old days too. How incredible is that? You know, it was cool to meet Dan. I told Dan I'd like to come back and really shoot this really good while it's still here, you know, before they take it out. And he said that was great, so.